Hello and welcome to the part 10 of installing SQL Server 2019 of video series, How to Set Up and Install Windows Server 2019 Hyper-V Setup Running SQL Server 2019 3-Node Multi-Subnet Always-On Cluster. Let's get going. So far, we have covered how to build the Hyper-V overall concept, and we talked about the different type of scenarios, and I demoed it to you how to do the failover and which scenario a 3-node multi-subnet cluster you might expect some outage where you need to do manual some activity to get it done. Then in the part 3 we talked about how the whole scripts and the downloads have been prepared for this particular series, so you can go back and take a look at the video number 3 to see how to download the scripts as well as how to set up your files so that you can follow this whole series and do it on your own. Then we prepared a Windows 10 laptop to boot a virtual hard disk where we installed an evaluation edition of Windows 10 to set up a Hyper-V con. And then we configure Hyper-V and the multiple networks which we'll be using for multi-subnet cluster. In the next step, we created something called Parent VHD, which we'll be using to create 5 of the VMs, which we'll be using in this exercise. And in the next one, we configured a virtual router, which allows you to share a connection, internet connection, so that all the VMs, even though they are in their own subnet, private LAN, they can still access the internet. After that, we configured a domain controller. And finally, in the last video, we created 4 different VMs, 3 for database servers and 1 for application server to set up always on. Now, in this series, let's continue with SQL Server installation. My name is Prakash Heda. I'm a MCD VA. I'm also working as a senior manager IT in SSNC Technologies. Plus, I also run a consultancy business for performance tuning for SQL Server. Please visit on my blog to take a look at the complete series. Connect me on LinkedIn or ping me on Twitter if you have any questions on this video. So, let's get going with the demo. Hello and welcome. So there were some challenges I faced when I was trying to install DB 123. What happens is that we were out of space, so the drive was a little bit full. So as we can see, so I made a couple of changes here. I want to walk you through so you can do it yourself. If you go to the VHD, I moved the app VHD onto the D drive because my C drive has this limited space. To here, and then went to the app server, right click on properties on the hard drive, and I changed the location to D drive where it's in another location. So that way one file we moved. Also, this is part of the demo where installation failed halfway, and this is the reason. What I did is I always create another location where I can just copy these 5 files, which I probably modify in between of installation or something goes wrong. And this really helped in this case because what I did is I just deleted the existing files and moved these 3 files, overwrite it onto the CVHD folder. And that way all the files were there. Good. So let's get going. So for the demo, we'll be installing SQL Server on 3 nodes. So I'm just gonna start it. So let's start PowerShell. Oh, another thing I want to talk about is that I made another change where our script create ISO, it was creating the drive on the C drive, which I changed it to the D drive because we didn't plan for this ISO file to begin with to be on the C drive. So that saves about 8 gig of space to be on the D drive. And with that, we are now almost having 35 GB of free space, so that should be good enough for our testing. There's another change I made to create ISO, is that I changed this script so that before it's recreating the file, what it does, everything under the C setup folder, it's gonna create an ISO out of it, create it here, and then before it starts that activity, it's gonna detach any of the virtual machine which has this drive attached. So it's gonna detach it, it will create the new ISO, and then finally it's gonna reattach it back to the VMD. So every time we run it, whatever we have under this folder, it's going to be converted to an ISO and attached to all the VMs. Some effort, some manual effort is saved here. Now that was some background. Now let's start with our install SQL Server project. What we want to do is first we're going to connect to one. And same as we did in the previous sessions, we're connecting, creating an EnterPS session. We are on DB1. We want to install SQL Server. So this is the command which will help us install SQL Server. As you know, the ISO we have created on D drive, it's basically attached to the VM. So if I go to the VM, right click settings, we can see ISO is attached there. In the VM, it's visible as D drive because we only have C drive in this VM. So that's why it's pretty simple to assume that D binaries will be able to get to this location. Then we are providing the SQL mode, file stream level, all these, many of these are optional, so you can ignore if you want. But for this testing purpose point of view, we are creating a default installation and a SQL Server, progress, service accounts, we are defining it as hvadmin. We want all the services to running with the domain account, which is domain admin in this case, just to keep this demo simple. Because if you're not creating it as a domain admin, then there are some other steps which you need to follow. And if this matters to you, then let me know in the comments and we'll probably create another session to talk about how to set up GMSA or group managed service accounts where it's the most secure way you can install SQL Server where nobody can access the service account passwords. Now, after that, this is the agent service account. We are setting it to be automated. This is another piece, the update source. Here we define what's the latest cumulative update by SQL Server so that as part of installation, it installs the cumulative update as well. In the part 3, where we downloaded all the installables for Windows Server 2019 and SQL Server 2019, and I showed you the GitHub, how it works, how can you download and use the GitHub portion. There, you saw that CU6 is what we downloaded in the last couple of months. CU8 is now available. So what you can do is you can open Chrome and search for SQL Server 2019 cumulative updates and get there. Let's see if it changed. No, it's cumulative update 8. Just click download. This will be downloaded. What you want to do is go back to the C drive. SQL setups, SQL binaries. Here we have SQL 2019, SPs, here CU8. So this is how the whole setup works, that we just created the CU8 folder, we put that CU in it, and now as part of installation, we are just pointing to CU8, and it's a start taking CU8 as the latest service cumulative updates. Then we accept the term services. We are defining who will be the sysadmin account here. Typical production setup, you'll have your DBA team or somebody from some group like that would be part of it. Here we are defining where the installation should be. This is a test environment, so everything on C drive in a typical production environment, it will be more complicated. Now, having said that, these are the features we are installing. As you know that by this version SQL 2019, RSS is a separate component, so you need to install it separately. SQL Server Data Tools, which is SSDT, is also a separate tool. Plus, SSMS has been separated for a while. So SSMS is now a separate product and we'll be installing SSMS right after this. Here's the command. We downloaded SSMS in the part 3, put it in the right place, and now we can just pass these parameters and it will install it. Since I'm connected to DB1, I'm just going to select this, right click, run selection. Meanwhile, this is running. There's no need to wait. This is the benefit of running from a central server. We just create another session to DB2 and DB3 and execute the same commands. So I'm going to open this, change it to DB2. Let's make a session to the server and then run these commands. And selection, perfect. Now let's create the third PowerShell ISC session. We'll open the script and run it on DB3 now. Once the session connected, you can see here we are connected to DB3. Right click, run selection. So as you can see, At this point, we have all the three installations running, DB3, DB1, DB2. And once this completes, which means we'll have SQL Server 29 installed, plus SSM is installed so that we can configure the next step of Windows cluster. All right, so we're back after SQL installation. As we can see, all three SQL servers installed. So let's connect to the VM. So our app server, let's try to connect to the first one. Let's connect to DB2. Perfect. So as you can see, all three databases are installed with the latest version of SQL Server 2019. We are all set. In the next video, I will cover how to install Windows cluster, which is going to be a pretty quick video because I'm going to teach you how to run a single line to create it, basically. All right. So thank you very much. And
thanks for watching the video. If you find video was useful for you, please click the like button so that YouTube algorithm can share it with others. I produce SQL Server related video, typically try to do one video a week. So if you are interested in knowing what's coming next, please subscribe and click on the notification bell. If you have any questions, please note it down in the comment section, or any requests for the future videos. Look forward to hear from you. Thank you.